Do your crypto trades keep failing? If you're still using Radium to perform any serious crypto transactions during high volume times, then you should stop, especially if you're trying to scalp tokens or day trade. Just getting new token contract addresses to load in Radium is difficult enough. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use BonkBot to quickly buy and sell a token right after it has launched or in times when there is a lot of trading volume on the token. During these times, it can be impossible to make trades. BonkBot is an application that you can add to Telegram to make crypto trades faster and flawless. Make sure to watch till the end so you can see my favorite BonkBot feature that could make you a lot more money. To get started with BonkBot, let's first make sure that we are hooking up the official bot to Telegram. The first thing you want to do is open up your Telegram group, and then you want to open up a browser, and we want to make sure that we're getting the official BonkBot. So we're going to go to BonkBot and hit enter, and then the top result should be from BonkBot.io. Left click on the result, which I'll also have linked in the description. In the menu bar on the top right, there's a button for start trading, and there's also one towards the bottom on the left. You can click either button and that will take you straight to the BonkBot inside of Telegram. And you can check out the BonkBot claim, make more money trading with Solana's fastest Telegram bot. Okay, let's go. Just hit the start button. And since I've used BonkBot before, it has recognized my wallet. So it sees that I currently have a balance of 1.5 SOL, but no open positions. And there's some brief instructions here. To buy a token, just enter the token address or paste a BirdEye or Pump Fund link. And we'll get to the advanced trading options after we set up a few things. The first thing that you're gonna wanna do is create a wallet. So you're gonna click on the wallet button. I already have a wallet, but if you don't have one, then there would be a button here to create a new wallet. And then once you create it, it will show you your address. And to copy your address, you would just click on it and that will copy it to the clipboard. And then you can paste that into Coinbase or Binance or wherever you're gonna send money from to fund this wallet. After you fund your wallet, I would recommend that you export the private key and then you can technically start trading. But first I recommend that you configure your settings. So we're going to click close on the wallet and then we're going to click on settings. And if you scroll up, you can see that there is actually a little bit of documentation here about what all the settings are. You don't really need to read this because that's what I'm here to explain. Okay, so settings or the announcements are when you check your positions. So right now announcements is green, so they're turned on and your positions are only gonna show if you have a minimum position value above 0.001 SOL. Auto buy is my favorite option. We'll get into this more later, but basically you just set this up and then whenever you paste a contract into Telegram, it'll automatically buy the token. Next, we have two buy buttons that we can configure. We can set the left and right buttons to the values that we trade most often. So to change the value, you would just left click on the button and then just type in a new value for that button to be set as quick access. And then that value will be updated on the button's config. And then we also have the sell buttons config, which is similar to the buy buttons, but these are going to be the quick access options to sell a token when you're ready. The left side button is defaulted to 25%, while the right is set at 100. And if we want to change these, we would just click on the button and then enter in the amount, the same as we did with the buy button config. After that, we have slippage. So under normal circumstances, 10% buy and 10% sell would be enough. But if you're trying to trade during a time when there's really high volume or a lot of action on the token, then the slippage should be set a lot higher. Because a lot of people are executing trades, the price is changing really quick. You're competing to buy a token, so I would change these to about 30% each. To do that, once again, click on the slippage button. So for buy, we're gonna set this to 30. So just type in 30 and hit enter. Now we get a confirmation message, buy slippage set to 30, and then now let's change the sell. So click on sell, and let's also set that to 30%. So type in 30 and hit enter, and you get your confirmation message. And you can also see that the buttons have been updated here. For price impact, 30% is pretty good, because if you're trading a relatively new token, there might not be a lot of liquidity. So if you're purchasing a relatively large amount, then you're going to impact the price quite a bit. But that's all right, because as an early investor, you're getting most of the tokens. Everyone who buys after you is going to get less tokens for spending the same amount of money as you. If anything, slippage is going to hurt you more than price impact, but it's not really going to matter if this token doubles in price or even does a 10 or 100x. The next setting is MEV protection. By default, this should be set to secure, and if you click on it, you can set it to turbo. Basically, secure is the default option, which means it might take a couple milliseconds longer to process a secure transaction. If you're competing to buy a token, then I would set this to turbo, and you can do that by left clicking on it. Okay, and then you should get a message below showing that MEV protection is set to turbo, which means that we're turning off the MEV protection. If you're just trading normally, not right after a token has just launched and there's a lot of traffic, then you should turn MEV protection on and set it to secure. Next, we have transaction priority, or the amount that you're going to pay for the fee for each transaction. If you click on the word medium here, you can flip through each transaction amount. So medium is 0.0015 SOL. And then if we click it, now we are set to high transaction priority, which means we will be giving a fee of 0.00750. So if you're competing on launch day for a token, I would set this as high as possible. So we're going to set that to very high. If it's a really popular token, I would say that you might even want to set a custom amount. To do that, just left click on the amount here. Now you can set the amount yourself. So I'm going to put 0.02. which at the time of recording, that's a little over $3. That's probably actually the minimum that I would set this to if I want my transaction to go through without any failures. And then press enter or the little arrow to set that value. Okay, and we got a confirmation message. Now we have finished setting everything up. Let's first go through a basic buy, and then we'll configure auto buy, and you can see the difference between the two. For our example, I'm going to go out and go to Dex Screener and pick out a random token. And I've decided to go with Costco Hot Dog. So I just need to grab the contract address. Here is the contract address. Let's copy it by left clicking. And then we go back to Telegram and go back to our bot. And in the message window, we just want to paste that down and hit enter. And after pasting the contract address, we get a little information about the token, such as the price, the percentage moves in the past 5 minutes, 1 hour, 6 hours, and 24 hours, along with the market cap, price impact of 5 SOL, 1.375, and then we also have a display of our wallet balance. So here are the quick buy options that we set up. And then we also always have the buy X, which is where we can enter a custom amount of SOL. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to use our quick buy button at 0.2 SOL. So I'm just going to left click that. All right, and transaction was sent, waiting for confirmation. And our swap was successful. We bought 826 Costco. And here is our position. If we want to refresh the position information, we can just click the refresh button on the bottom. It's only been a couple of seconds. There hasn't been a lot of movement. But when we are ready, we can use the sell buttons, sell 25%, sell 100%, and then we also have that custom sell option. Now we are going to sell our position. I'm going to get rid of everything, so I'm going to press on the sell 100% button. Transaction sent, waiting for confirmation. And we got the confirmation, swap successful, sold 826 cost for 0.2. which is basically the same exact amount that we purchased it for, so that's good. So that's what a basic buy looks like. Now let's do the automatic buy. To set up automatic buy, we're going to go back into settings. So we're going to type /, select settings. And now where it says auto buy, we're going to enable auto buy by clicking on the button that says disabled. Auto buy is now enabled, except the auto buy amount is way too high, 5 SOL. We don't even have that in our wallet, so we're going to change that by left clicking on it. And for this tutorial, we're going to auto buy at 0.5 SOL. Enter in your amount and press enter. And then we go check our settings again. And this looks correct. Auto buy is enabled. And the auto buy amount is 0.50. So basically what this is going to do is save us a couple of clicks. When we go to do the buy this time, all we're going to have to do is paste in the contract and it's automatically going to open up that position. But for the sell side, the options are going to be the same. Some people might call this feature sniping, but to me it does not really fall into that category. If you want to try out a great sniping bot for Telegram, then check out my sniper bot video linked in the description or the card at the top right. If this video helped in any way, please consider giving this video a like and a subscribe so that more people can find this answer.